Saturday night, or it's midnight, I guess early morning. Welcome to Drome Late Night Presents Kitten2Cougar with me, Paris Kennedy, and Sally Mullins.
Hi!
My awesome co-host and partner in crime in every way. Today's a special episode, and I feel like I should transfer myself into that energy. This is the bitch episode. And the reason it's the bitch episode is because we decided that it was going to be the bitch episode. Because I went to, we both had shit going on last weekend, or Halloween weekend. I went to New Orleans for Halloween, and my costume was amazing, and it looked really amazing, but whatever. But I always get Sally like silly shirts and stuff because she loves silly shirts. That's what we get each other. That's kind of like the gift that we always get each other is silly
romantic.
Shirts. It's romantic. It's our thing. It's like, you know. So I found this Vicious shirts and I was like, oh my God, they have them in black and white. We need to get them matching. And we had a very important business lunch at our usual place, The Wall.
Great Wall on Sherman Way.
Great Wall on Sherman Way, where the last scene of Drive was filmed. I like to throw that in there because people talk shit about the Valley and I'm like, those movies you like were shot there. Boogie Nights, Drive, okay. But we were there and I was like, Vicious, what should the theme be? And we're like, just bitches, just be bitches.
Yeah.
So we're just gonna be bitches this episode and like, that's just gonna come naturally.
Yeah,
you know?
We have a really cute guy and we're just gonna be like,
he's very cute. Sally sent me his
balls.
Picture. And I was like, he looks like a young Republican. Like, he looks really, like, wholesome and stuff. And then I think he made a funny joke back, and I was like, okay, cool, he's funny. He, like, joked back. Like, usually the guys are like,
What does that mean?
They're just like, oh, what time should I show up and stuff. They don't, like, joke back or anything. So I was like, okay,
oh, that's
cool.
Kind of rude.
That
I
made
know
him
they were
stick
like
out
that.
To me. So I was like, okay, he's already being funny.
He has a sense of humor, which is a good thing for a stand-up comedian.
It's true. Some people don't. And they're stand-up comedians. Like, they come in, they don't retweet the stuff, and they act all snobby, and they come in here, and they're just like, I do my, you know, other shows where I don't get paid, but I'm here.
They take their stand-up pretty seriously.
They don't, they don't report.
they don't report. Yeah,
they were even here.
Yeah.
And we're like, okay, well, go in the back of that fucking McDonald's and do your set.
They're so embarrassed to be on our show. They don't have
to be. Don't be on a live streaming show with actual viewers all around the world. Hey, guys.
Don't do us any favors.
Please don't do us any favors, because there's a lot of people that want to be on the show. So if you don't, and you're not going to retweet our shit, okay.
And another thing, musicians, musicians, get over it.
We were going to have a special musician guest, and he fucking flaked, so get over
it. Yeah, 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 and, you know, like, made me wait a while for the text and everything, so kind of just over musicians right now. We're sticking to male comics.
We haven't had one comic flake yet.
No, the comics
come
show through, okay?
The musicians, not so much. That's fine, whatever, we didn't need him anyway. Our guest for that show will be even better.
Yeah,
it
works out.
So what are you up to? We are both leaving town like very soon. I'm leaving first, and then you're leaving. Where are you going?
I am freaking out. I am going overseas. I'm entertaining the troops. Yeah, it was supposed to be 2 weeks. Yeah, she was so great last year. Everyone was jealous. I'm on this tour, and Paris is like, "You're having the time of your life." You know, she's happy for
me.
Well,
I'm not a stand-up, so like, I'm not gonna be like, "I wish I was there." Like, what am I gonna do there? You know, I could still be jealous of fucking soldiers.
You're just not a hater. You know,
I'll just go down to Camp Pendleton and drive down there and fuck soldiers.
You're
right.
You know what? You know what?
Soldiers
on this
local.
Episode,
I fuck local.
You are a hater. You are a hater. So you need to be like, bitch, you had to travel around the world. I could go to Camp Pendleton. It's like a hitchhike. Bitch, you had to get on a plane.
That's a funny story.
Craigslist.
I did drive down it. When I did hardcore porn, I drove to San Diego to do a scene with this girl, and she was like, let's stop at Camp Pendleton. I'm like, why? And she's like, oh, I love to stop there. The guys are so excited to see pretty girls, and they take you to the mall and take you shopping and stuff.
Whoa.
And like, so basically, like, and we were like 19 at the time. So I'm like, basically, you like go to a military base by yourself and with a bunch of guys and like
did they take you shopping?
I guess they took her shopping, but I'm pretty sure they probably ran a few trains on her too. I mean, like, she was pretty ballsy to just go to like a military base by yourself and be like, hey, I'm a hot porn star, like, everybody gang
they must have gone nuts.
Yeah, I'm sure that there was lots of nuts all over her face.
These nuts.
Jesus Christ. I was like, you're crazy. We're going to get raped and murdered.
They seem like they were cool, though, huh?
I didn't meet them personally. I don't know what happened to her. She's not important anymore. So for all I know, she got murdered by one of them. I don't know. I don't inquire into other people's business.
I hope this shit goes a little better. My tour, you know, we'll see.
You're going to all kinds of cool places in Europe, mm-hmm. right? Mm-hmm. Last time she got to go to like the Caribbean. It was
Kosovo. I heard the last
Kosovo.
Time. Yeah, I heard somebody I know
that
there.
That still exists.
They got to see a mass grave like 10 years ago. I don't know if these things are still like chilling and everything, but. I don't know. How would you feel if somebody said, like, do you want to see a mass grave?
I would want to see anything. Anything fucked up, like, I'm going to see it. Like, I'm that girl that's going to look if there's a car crash. I just want to see what's going on.
I'm not
going to look for a long, morbid time, but for a few seconds, I want to know what's going on. I just want to know what's going on. I'm not going to turn my head all the way around, rubberneck, but I'm going to turn it to the side.
Yeah.
Do a little profile neck.
Yeah.
Take a glance.
Peripheral.
Take a little glance.
I am going to
disappear into the mountains in a cabin.
Cabin
and
in the woods.
And maybe snowboard and have my dogs and cook pancakes and bacon and eggs for breakfast and be a mountain man, except a woman, you know. But mountain man sounds cooler than mountain
man. So we're both going to be away for Thanksgiving.
We are.
But we will have an episode.
We are going to have a special episode that we're going to pre-record like our Halloween one. That was so popular. People loved it. So we're doing that right after this, actually. It's going to be a long night, but I like it. I was excited to come here all day. And I'm excited to check out this comic.
He's cool.
Sally knows I like blondes. It's my weakness for blondes. All my exes are blonde, except for like one. Remember Vuk?
Oh, yeah. But he was light brown.
And then he had blue eyes. And so he was basic. He was like Serbian. So he was like basically.
Yeah, she likes, the kind of, you know, really waspy look and everything. And she dated some really cute blue-eyed guys.
Blonde hair, blue eyes, my weakness. I don't know. It's exotic to me as a mixed-race woman.
As a woman of mixed race, a woman of mixed desires
and races. So why don't you introduce this awesome comic?
He is really cool. I have worked with him at the Comedy Store. And he also works with the Josh and Josh show at Bar Lubitsch. Please give it up for an up-and-coming young comedian. Let's hear it for Hunter Hudson.
Yay! Thank you, ladies.
Appreciate it. Sorry.
I know. He works out, too.
I won't talk during your set.
Thank you. Wow, that arms thing threw me off. That's all right. I'm going to start.
You look good.
Do you girls ever get catcalls, ever?
Never.
No,
it doesn't happen.
Catcalling's gross. It's got to be really annoying. It also never works. A woman's never stopped in her tracks and been like, excuse me, you think I'm hot? Let's have sex. I'm so glad you said something. It's never happened. And yet guys continue to catcall, women continue to get angry about it, which is dumb, because if teen comedies starring female leads have taught us anything, it's that you don't get mad, you get even. So next time ladies are out hanging out outside, a cute guy walks by, say some gross shit to him.
I like it.
Hey cutie, I'm on my period.
Oh, is that gross?
Hello, handsome. Sometimes when I do anal, a little bit of poop comes out. We'll see if it stops. Speaking of anal, what's with these hookers that aren't on PayPal? Am I right? No, I don't have $300 of cash on me, Tamara, you freak. Now spit in my mouth and tell me you love me.
Oh, shit.
Ever try to negotiate with a hooker? It's not easy. Yes, how much to cuddle and watch 10 Things I Hate About You? I do think they should make prostitution legal. With all these mass right?
Yeah.
I think it would really cut down on these mass shootings. I've never read an online manifesto, but I'm pretty sure none of them go, I'm sick and tired of getting all this pussy!
It's all right.
You're hilarious.
You got time.
Yeah.
I know some people that like to choke during sex. What's with that? Call me old-fashioned, but I just like to choke. That gasp. yes, it's my favorite. So I'm single. If you like that segue, it's my only one. I'm single. I'm single for a lot of reasons. I think one of the main reasons is I don't have the emotional maturity for a relationship based on the fact that most of my iPod is Taylor Swift and Limp Bizkit.
Woo!
That's too much of an emotional swing. I don't know about you, but I'm feeling 22. And I did it all for the nookie. Come on, the nookie. Come on. It's too... Nobody wants to date that. Nobody wants to lie in bed watching a romantic comedy and feel my gun beneath her pillow. Yes, baby, my gun is loaded. An unloaded gun is just a stick. I'm single for a lot of reasons. Single because no woman ever says, I like my men like I like my condoms. Really thin and broke. I struggle with online dating, partly because I have this Hitler youth face, and my favorite women are Jewish women. It just doesn't really work on J-Date. Probably also doesn't help that my status says, looking for Jews, in all caps. I do have a little bit of Hitler in me, though, because I do have a favorite race. My favorite race is mixed race. So I don't even know who to kill to make more of them. Because if your favorite drink is a Frappuccino, you need milk and coffee and juice to make the perfect mix. The only thing I've thought of to make more mixed kids is to have the guy at City Hall who passes out marriage licenses have a paint swatch. And when a couple comes up to get married, he judges them, you're snowy white and you're... off beige? Too close. Sorry. We come back when one of you gets a tan, but I suggest you see other people. Thank you so much. That's my time. This was super fun.
Come sit down with us. Bring your microphone. That's okay. You got to bring your microphone.
That's right. Got to bring my microphone. The mic the whole show.
Oh my God. I need to say some things. First of all, during your set, I guess they can't turn our mics off. So you're going to hear. He's my soulmate.
Yeah.
And then you're going to hear, I've been trying to start a Limp Bizkit cover band.
That was all her.
So just so you know, that's what you're going to hear at some point during your set. But I think we kept it pretty cool.
Yeah. That you will hear that.
That's great.
Yeah.
That's true. I've been trying to start an all-girl Limp Bizkit cover band. I thought that would be hilarious, but no one seems to understand how hilarious that is. I guess I'm the only one who thinks that's fucking hilarious.
Well, it would be great.
Nobody wants to join in. Yeah. Right?
I know all the words.
Because that I grew up. Well, yeah, I'm older than you, but how old are you? That's the first thing we need to ask.
How old are you?
How old are you?
I am 26.
Woo! Okay. Perfect. Good age. Yeah.
Right. So, and then what else did he say? He said all this stuff. We're like,
how long have you been in comedy?
Yeah.
For about 5 years now. Mm-hmm. I started when I was 21 at a little bar called The Funny Stop in Akron, Ohio.
Oh, cool. Where are you from?
I was going to guess Ohio. I don't know.
Yeah, we're smart.
I don't think anyone goes to Akron.
I have an ex from Ohio.
For an open mic.
From Northeast Ohio? Or?
He's from... Which one? Shane is from Ohio.
Oh, wow.
Somewhere.
Oil rig.
Some shithole. Experience. Small town. So it goes with the theme. I don't know. Some... Not like a big city, so you know, like buttfuck Ohio.
Well,
I don't know.
That's most.
BFEO. So Hunter, you moved to LA to pursue stand up.
Yes, pursue stand up.
How long have you been here?
I've been here 2 years.
Okay, where do you live?
I live.
Tell me your exact address. You can tell the general area.
Put it on the screen.
I live in Fullerton. Orange County, but not really Orange County.
That's where Vuk was from. Why does this keep coming up?
Yeah.
This is like, I've just been calling your ex-boyfriend.
This should be the ex-boyfriend edition.
Yeah. Crazy ex-boyfriend.
Fullerton, and then now where do you live? You live in Fullerton now?
That's where I live now, yeah.
Okay, so you came a long way to be on this.
Thank you. Show. It's not so bad this late at night.
Traffic wasn't bad. Zipped on the beer.
Yeah, sweet. Yeah, but still, like, people act like, oh my God.
It's because they don't
know. I need a ride. Will you call my Uber? An Uber for me.
Yeah. You know what? There's a lot of good gigs in Orange County, too. There really are.
Fullerton is actually pretty cool. My ex was from Fullerton. Orange County.
Christian. We both dated a guy who lived with his parents in Fullerton.
Okay, Christian too. Yeah. Also Vu. That's not who I was talking about. But I totally forgot.
I'm sorry, but you gotta include me.
I forgot that we dated the same guy.
Same guy.
Well, she dated him first.
Oh, and then, say at the same time?
No. That's too incestuous for us. That's weird.
Yeah.
We have boundaries.
Come on, man.
We have boundaries.
What do we look like?
I waited like a month after she dated him.
Yeah.
Okay. She was dating a guy. I thought he was cute, and I met him at a party where I was with my ex-husband because I got married at 18. This blonde ex-neo-Nazi, so white.
Yes.
Then at the party, I met him, and then I was getting divorced, and she wasn't seeing that guy anymore. And I was like, she was like, which one of my guy friends do you want to hook up with?
Yeah.
Because I was like, I need some sex.
Yeah.
And I was
like, what about Christian? Hell? Yeah. And he had hurt my feelings. It wasn't like someone I had kicked to the curb and trying to throw her some, you know, bunk leftovers. So I'm like, this guy's cool. I wanted more.
I didn't know that he had, like, you know.
He was closer to her age than mine. You know me, Coug from way back.
He was older than me. Yeah.
Yeah. He was in between our ages.
Yeah. He was wedged right in between us. But then it all comes back around because I had a Halloween party or whatever. Mm-hmm. I invited him to it randomly. Like, this was like 2 or 3 years ago.
And he looked great.
And he came and he looked great.
So
and it was
I
like years.
Him.
And he was like lurking around, you know, around, like looking uncomfortable and stuff. And then he like found Sally and I was, you know, into some other guy. Or I think I was in a relationship. I don't know what.
You had a boyfriend.
I don't remember.
Yeah.
I can't remember these things. But she's like, I don't want to go. And I'm like, do it.
Do it.
It's been years.
You guys
been
back and forth
it's been years.
Him?
Yes.
No.
Yes.
He and I were in a relationship for 8 months.
And then years later,
he came to one of my parties. And then she was like, do you care? Do you mind if I? And I was like, no, go for it. Like, please. Like, you know, by all means.
And we wanted to have him on the show.
I wanted her to go get that because we both knew at least he was good
like,
for good sex.
She was like, hit that and report back.
He was good for good sex. Yeah.
Yeah. Hit
he was
that and report
good.
Back.
We'll give him that credit.
He's
the bitch
super
edition.
Nice.
It's a bitch edition. But in case you're watching, Christian, at least, you know, you ate pussy.
Yeah.
We appreciate that because there are some guys that I guess. It's 2015, I don't know. But
you drank my beer, but you always had your own weed.
I did.
Yeah.
We had a lot of fun. We do cocaine and go to jazz clubs. It was a wild
He was
time.
Down to party,
This was
whatever.
A long time. Let me make it clear, this was a very
was.
Long time ago. This was after my first marriage and before my second marriage, so I must have been like 22 or something. Because I got married again at 24.
And he loved her.
Asshole.
He loved her. See, sometimes when a guy
like
hurts me a little, I'm like, hey, go get your heart broken by Paris. You know?
I don't think he's watching. But I broke his heart. I was really mean to him because he started to get on my nerves, and then I was like, and I was young, and you were thinking about not being emotionally mature, and I was like 22, so I was just like, you're too needy. Get away from me. And then I broke his heart, but then it was revenge because he hurt her.
Yeah, so I was down. I was condoning
she
the heartbreak.
She loved it.
Karma.
She loved that. I broke his heart.
Stick it. But here's the best part is we wanted him to be on Kitten2Cougar because he's an actor, and we wanted him to come and do a monologue and kind of thing. And then we check out his Facebook, and he's got, like, this girlfriend, like, real serious, like, heavy-duty girlfriend. So we were like, fuck it.
And he didn't for a long time.
We're like, fuck it. We don't want drama, you know?
We usually try to have guys on the show that, like, at least one of us can fuck afterwards.
Yeah, so. Because the guys have been bringing their girlfriends on the show, you
was
know?
Usually they're single, but, like, every once in a while they'll bring a girlfriend, and we're like, oh, okay, like, you could have told us.
I think that when the guy accepts the gig,
every girl that a guy
has
been
really
has been super
nice,
sweet and nice
and beautiful
and
just amazing, like homage. But I think what happens is that the guys like
we welcome them while
know,
we curve on their guys on there.
Yeah, like the guys like
cool
yes,
it, yeah.
And then the girl's like, "What's this show you're going on Saturday night?"
Probably the guy's like, "It's a sex talk show." The girl's like, "I'm coming with you."
Yeah, yeah.
All right.
But these
when
girls,
they don't realize
yeah.
this is PG. R rated, but it's not X rated.
It's R13.
But we can't R-13. Get naked or anything. I wish we did a bikini episode.
We would love to get naked.
And that was about how Oh, you saw that one. You watched
it? Oh, yeah. Tom Allen. Very good. Well, we appreciate it. Well, that's what I love about Hunter.
I don't think some of these comics even watch their own episodes. When just
I know. They won't retweet them. You know, when I said to Hunter, would you be on our show? He goes, I'm a fan of that show. And we're like, yay. You know, how cool.
Tom and I had a sketch writing class together. I know Tom.
He's such a good guy. Oh, yeah.
He was such a beautiful, really cute guy. His tweets are funny. I know.
He's out of control. I love him. He has this wild side. I can't believe it.
Elsa totally, where I was on the mic and I was like, oh my God.
Yeah.
I don't remember what it was, but maybe it'll come back around. But let's go right into talking about blow off lines since this is the bitch one.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Talk about blow off lines. So this is not like, oh, we want to let a guy down gently. This is like, this guy's been annoying, he's been bugging us, or he's like so beneath us, and then he's trying to like ask us out, and we're like, excuse you, like why would you even think that either of us would say yes? And it's insulting, and it hurts our feelings. Like, fuck their feelings. Like, what about us?
Look, like, I'm flattered, but I'm going to take the cue from her and be a bitch. Okay.
It's a bitch edition. So,
let's set it up that, first of all, Hunter is going to be, like, maybe, like a bro type, or, like, maybe, kind of spiky hair, like, the kind of guy who has maybe, like, a bird of prey tattoo on his body or something.
Maybe a black crow's tattoo.
Christian.
Sorry, that was an inside joke.
Rides a crotch bike. You know, he's kind of like what people would call like douchey, like a bit of a poser.
I think you probably know a bro. You're from Ohio. You know exactly what a bro is.
But like a lot of product.
Went to school with them.
Maybe a spray tan is in the works.
Okay, so you're a bro, and Sally is a beautiful woman.
Well, you're trying to pick us both up, so you can throw lines.
But do them one at a time.
Yeah.
Let me be the director here just so it doesn't turn into chaos. So hit on Sally first. She'll do her blow off line. So just do a cheesy like bro line, and then maybe we can change up his character and he'll hit on me. I already got mine because it's the same bluff line I always use when it's a fucking asshole or a douchebag. But we should go in order.
All right. So first,
I'm all about order.
Like an older woman, older bitch over here. I'm here chilling in the bar. All right. Sounds good.
All right.
Order in the court.
I love your sports jersey. You're into sports. You want to do like a Jaeger bomb or something, or like a bunch of Jaeger bombs?
I'd do a bunch of them alone. Yeah. I mean, you're right about that. Hey, you don't look like you wear Ed Hardy, but you look like you miss it.
You're so good. Oh, my God.
I'll be back at last call.
Cool. To me, this is like a good connection. I don't know.
I feel chemistry between you.
Yeah,
two,
I like that.
Would you say that you're more submissive or dominant in the bedroom?
Dominant.
Yay! Oh my God! But he kind of was embarrassed.
And the younger guys usually aren't. They don't get dom until later. Well,
no.
Well, he could be into younger women, and then it would make sense that he's a dom because he could be like, I'm a 26-year-old dom into 18-year-old women. And then it makes sense.
Yeah, that makes sense.
We'll get into that
barely
later.
Legal.
We will get into your age preference later, and then we will either be a bitch to you about it or not, depending on whether it's favorable to us. Okay, so now let's see who could.
Good.
What's another good thing? He could be a hipster. Okay, now you're a hipster, and we're in a stupid douchey East Side fucking bar, and I'm sitting there.
Oh my God, I have an allergy to hipsters.
I'm gonna use my usual line though, just so because. And they know, and my Twitter followers will recognize this line because I say it to people who say stupid shit to me all the time.
It's like old bitch chilling to the side, vintage.
So have you heard the new Mumford & Sons? And do you want to talk about it a lot?
Could you die slowly burning in a fire?
That's so like hack mainstream, like a dry ice fire.
I'm going to murder you and your whole family and burn your house down. It always comes back to arson somehow. But it usually makes them leave. So you, as a guy, like, for a guy, probably, like, a girl coming up to you in a bar and hitting on you is, like, cool, because that doesn't usually happen. Usually you have to...
Almost never.
All the pressure has to be...
What?
I bet you get hit on all the time. But do you ever get hit on and, like, it's, like, a really annoying chick or something like that, or, like, someone... I don't know, you're so nice. Like, do you have...
Or, like, a cougar?
Can you be a bitch? I don't mean like a bitch in the way a man's a bitch. I mean a bitch in the way a woman's a bitch. Because a man bitch is a whole different thing.
Yeah.
That's like the guys that I've been fucking dating lately.
Hey, why don't we be obnoxious girls and bother him, like, one at a time? Like, I'll be, like, this really nasty, obnoxious coug, and you gotta be really mean to me. And it's okay. You can be as mean
as
fuck.
I'm gonna be, like, a stupid airhead.
Yeah, young airhead. Okay, I'll go first as the old coug or something.
And then you give us your best line of how you would handle the situation.
Okay. All right, I'll just be, I'm gonna be a disgusting grunt.
If I was an asshole.
Bring out your inner bitch for the bitch edition of Kitten2Cougar. Okay.
Oh, my God. Oh my God, I wish I were 20 years younger, but then I'd be so fucking hot, you wouldn't have a chance, bitch.
Someone's a little overconfident from their Zumba classes.
Buy me a drink. It's on.
You deserve a drink for that. Oh, yeah.
See? That works for guys.
He just said that your body looked good.
Yeah, he did. It was a compliment. Right. Close
and I'm
and
a
insult.
Stupid, like, basic dumb bitch. Okay, let me think of something. Oh, this is hard because I'm so unbasic that it's like really hard to pull up the basic.
That was kind of hard for me to be a big loser like that.
I know, you're so, right? We're really reaching here. Like, we are
dig deep.
Probably the best actresses
deep.
I know.
Give this bitch an Oscar.
Oh my God, you're so cute. What fraternity are you in? Do you want to do Jaeger bombs?
So what percent of your head is actual cum?
Oh my God, I love cum.
You guys both rolled with the blow off lines pretty well.
Yeah, we're really.
You guys were not easily discouraged.
No, we're not. We really have been in some abusive relationships. This really can bother us.
We both had worse. There's nothing you could say.
Yeah, there's nothing you could do.
Nothing you could say.
There's nowhere you could hit. There's nothing you could burn.
We've learned from those times, though, haven't we?
No, we've never. No,
all those guys, most of those guys are still in our lives, fucking with our heads.
Yeah, here and there.
Watching our dogs.
When their phones work, they're watching our dogs.
Selling our phones for meth.
Yeah, exactly. Flipping phones and shit.
Not naming names. So we do this segment every week, and it's our favorite, so we do it every week. Because, there it is.
Yep.
Hot dead guy of the week. Ooh, so it's a guy that's dead that we think is really hot, and we're sad that he's dead. Some people, you're like, world's overpopulation.
Yeah.
There's some guys that you're like, no, he's too pretty. He's too beautiful.
Yeah.
So today, it's a really old school, cool person that Sally thought of because of the shirts, inspired it. Sid Vicious from Sex Pistols, babe.
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
yeah. Yeah, he's cute. Yeah,
woo, hi, Sid. He was really cute. I like tattooed guys.
Oh, the
right
is
guys,
so cute. Yeah.
I know. Look, he's smiling.
And he had, like, really toned arms.
Do you know who that is? This 26-year-old?
Yes.
Okay. I've asked people, like, we've had guys on the show who have no idea who our dead guy is, and I'm like, that guy was, like, not that, like, he had a show in the 90s.
Gary Oldman, that was, like, his breakout performance playing Sid Vicious
so
and Sid and Nancy.
Good.
He was so amazing.
I haven't seen it in forever, and I want to rewatch it now.
I want to watch it with you. I just want to watch it with you.
I'm going to get it on Blu-ray, and we'll watch it. We'll have a Sid and Nancy
night. Let's
watch it. We're going to do a Sid and Nancy something else later, but first we'll just talk about him. So, he was in Sex Pistols. Oh. How did he die?
He actually passed away of an overdose of heroin that, interestingly enough, his mom was said to have procured for him. It was really a weird situation. Well, he was raised by a single mom, and she was kind of an enabler to him when he was growing up. Yeah,
speaking of heroin.
Get him drunk. When he was growing up, his mom would kind of let him get high and drunk, but she never got him into heroin. And then when he got in the Sex Pistols, he met this American bird by the name of Nancy Spungen, who was a bit of a groupie and a bit of a dominatrix and a little model and some blue movies, as you called them. Oh,
thanks.
Awesome. Yeah, triple threat, exactly. And she ended up, like, kind of enabling him into heroin.
Yeah, it was kind of like Courtney and Kurt. It was like the drugs were bound them together.
Yeah.
And in a way, that's romantic. Cheers.
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 Clink.
Cheers.
Clink.
I do remember the part in the movie where he killed her. I mean, this is known that he stabbed her. He was in, like, a frenzy. They were on a heroin frenzy, so it was, like, confusing. In the movie, like, they're fight. Like, it didn't seem like, it was premeditated.
He loved her so much.
It was just like,
I'm on heroin, stab.
Yeah.
Or if she asked him, or if he did it once. I mean, but he had showed violence on several occasions.
They fought violently all the time. But in the movie, like, they're just kind of fighting, and then they're in bed, and then, he, like, stabs her, and then they go to bed, and she's, like, forgot she stabbed him, and she, like, gets up, and there's all blood, and she, like, crawls to the bathroom, and she's like, yeah.
But he'd had issues with, like, a friend of his, a musician friend's brother, he'd beaten up. And then there were some people, like, people when, you know, in the punk scene, they're doing things on stage and a fan will, like, throw something or a heckler will hit them in the head and then he'd, like, jump. I mean, he had, like, a couple of assault convictions, basically.
I like that.
He was wild. He was young, wild, man. Young, wild, lanky motherfucker. And he looks really cute.
I like aggressive guys. I like really aggressive guys. So, like, that's hot to me.
But I don't know if he was. He was, like, probably about 20. And Nancy had sex with him. She really, like, turned him out sexually. I mean, he was pretty much almost a virgin.
He was 20 when he died?
He was about 21 when he died of an overdose. It was like she... He was out on bail for her murder. And he passed away. He had a new girlfriend, whatever. And
what?
His mom procured him heroin.
Whoa.
Yeah, that's what I don't like.
Yeah, no, that would be romantic if he came out of jail and, like, was like, I can't live without her, I'm gonna die. And then he got another girlfriend. Fuck you, Sid.
Well, he was an enabled mommy's boy. I do believe he loved Nancy very much.
Mama's boy.
Nancy was just terror, though. There's an amazing book called And I Don't Want to Live This Life. It's written by her mother trying to deal with her trauma. She was like a screamer. Yeah, it's really great.
She screams really great. And the woman who plays
Chloe
her, she's
Webb.
Like,
oh, she's amazing.
She's
Chloe
like,
Webb,
it does that, like...
But Sid!
Sid, yeah. She's like smoker's cough voice, you know. Do you know any of the Sex Pistols music?
I don't. It's a little
I'm kind of, it was before my time. I mean, he died before I was
born. I have a really cute story.
I know like a song or two.
He's British. My dad is British. And he was a reporter in England. And he was like 31. And he tried to interview Sid and Johnny Rotten. And they're like, we're not going to talk to you. Too bloody old. My dad was 31. he wasn't even my dad yet. But that's so cute.
That's so funny. Oh, my God.
He told me about those guys. Because they were up-and-coming young musicians and everything, you know.
Up-and-coming, maybe they would have been in Kitten2Cougar back in the day. Because we specialize in up-and-coming. We don't want ones who are already
I got my years
used
confused.
Up. We don't want the used-up comics. We want the ones that are, like, fresh.
I got my years confused. Oven. Yeah. We want the up-and-coming comics. We don't want the divas. We don't
we
want to the
make them
you
so
know?
Then that way they can be like, oh, because they're famous because they were on our show. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's
we
what
have
we want.
Viewers
we want thirsty comics, you know.
We haven't struggled yet finding a guest.
Yeah. Only problem is musicians.
Musicians, like.
But anyway. But we are paying homage to a musician on this show.
Yes.
We like our musicians dead.
They're better off dead. My dad's a musician, and it would be great if he was dead. But he's not. He's not, but he'll be soon enough. And then I've dated musicians, and it's just... Comics are worse, but musicians are pretty bad too. Yeah. Comic is like comics, musicians. I'm done. I think I've gone back to musicians, but I'm thinking about like maybe pro
actors
now or athletes, like pro athletes. Like I think I
pro
would
athletes would
be a
good
really
girls.
Good like NFL wife.
Oh, you'd be great.
You could take a punch.
I could take a punch like no one else, dude. And I like.
She'd be perfect for that.
I'd be perfect because I could take a punch. I'll, you know.
Will not report.
So I'll stand. I'm ride or die, and I'll be like, no, I fell. I fell down, and my eye hit something.
She would be
work
totally
on the story.
Great.
I would. Yeah, I'll work. I'm gonna work on it later. I'm home tonight. And my future. And then I get all this fucking money, and then he goes and plays football. It's great.
Yeah, that's awesome.
So that's the setup right there. The problem is there. It's really hard to find, like, them on OkCupid and Tinder and stuff.
Athletes?
Is there a
Isn't
Tinder
there like
just
the
for
athletes
pro athletes?
Just com, yeah. Farmers only.
Seekingarrangement.com, maybe. No, those are mostly like lawyers and stuff.
Fuck.
I wouldn't know about any of those sugar daddy
men
sites.
In uniform? Isn't a sports uniform a uniform?
Yeah, I want a man in any kind of, I like a man in any kind of uniform.
I'll take a janitor.
Well, Joey was a plumber. My ex-husband was a plumber for a minute.
Oh, that's cool.
He had a uniform.
Uniform involves a butt crack? We're down.
Yeah. Wow.
So Sid just died in the 80s, and I incorrectly reported my age. Anyway, enough. We'll move on.
Red flags.
We have another segment called Red Flags that we do. Red flag alert. This is
love the
dating
graphic.
Advice from us because Sally is a comic and I am an adult actress, but we are both experts at sex because we've been doing this for so long. Yeah. And I say if you've been doing something more than, 12, 13 years, you can call yourself an expert. Doctors go to school for less years than that.
I respect that.
Have a piece of paper, so they get to be called doctors. I'm a fucking doctor, self-proclaimed.
I think that's fun. I think you have a doctorate
in a lot of... So we can give you advice.
That's driving me crazy.
Red flags. So, Sally, do you have a red flag for this week?
Yeah, I'm going to say... cameras and camera phones, of course. I'm not talking about some Polaroid action, but if you're on a date with a hipster, that's cool. If you spend some money on the film, that's a good sign. It's $35 for the Polaroid film if he's snapping that.
If he's any hipster from L.A., then he's not going to have the money for film.
No, you're fucked. He'll just be talking and dreaming of Polaroids. But if you're out with a guy, all right, I can understand he's not taking the first date picture of the two of you together. I can understand that. He doesn't want to put a label on it. He's chill. But if he's going to take a picture of himself, a selfie, he should at least take a picture of you as well. Watch for the guy who, you think he's taking a picture of you. The camera comes up and everything. And you're like, ooh, cool. But he's just getting another selfie, selfie after selfie. The selfie meister. That's a problem. Or... you say to him, let me get a picture of you over here. And then he doesn't turn it back around on you.
He doesn't want to show that he's with you. There's a reason for that, honey.
Or he just has no interest. Yeah. Why?
He doesn't. I'm saying to the honeys out there, I would never call you honey. That's like.
I don't mind.
I was talking down to people. No, I would never talk down. I was talking down to these dumb bitches.
Yeah.
I don't get these guys. If they want to date you and show people they're with you, they will. If they're hiding you, then they probably want to look like they're single still.
Yeah, so they want to look like they're single and they're in love with themselves. And, honey, you ain't got a chance. Move it along.
You ain't got a chance. If a guy wants to show you off, he will.
Yeah.
I have red flag. I thought about it a lot today. And then I was like, what did I do for the last one? And then I thought of one. And then I was like, I think that's what I did for the last one. So I'm gonna take it to the mom zone. Mommy issues. I'm gonna talk about mommy issues. I have daddy issues, so I don't judge, but I wouldn't recommend dating me, so I feel like I could say this. So either red flag, a guy who does not get along with his mom, or a guy who gets along with his mom way too much. Both of those have the same outcome, which
Norman
is
Bates.
Mommy.
Norman Bates,
mommy.
Yeah.
Norman Bates. If they were too close to their mom, then they're very, it's like creepy. It's like you're also their.
And if they call had a fight with their mom by their first name.
And then if they're not cool with their mom and close, then they need a replacement mom, and then again, you're a mom. So try to find
issues.
Someone with like a neutral, relationship with their mom, just like someone who's. Doesn't have mommy issues.
I love that red flag. The calling your mom by her human name.
Yes.
Weird.
That
weird.
Is what? A weird thing. Trax did that. My ex Trax did that. And I'm like, who are you on the phone with? He's like, Helen.
And it was his mom?
Yeah.
That's
they're
weird.
Like adult friends? Yeah, that's weird.
Yeah.
No,
yeah.
Weird. I'm not close with my mom and I still call her mom.
Party buddies. Yeah.
I'm not going to call her by her name. That's
weird. Yeah,
weird. She's not my office worker.
No, that's weird. The guy I'm dating now, when he talks to his dad, he picks up the phone and he goes, hey, boy. Like, I think that's weird, too. It's a little weird, right?
Oh, he calls his dad
boy? He calls his dad boy. He's like,
No,
he calls his dad that. I think it's a little bizarre, but it's okay. I still like him.
I don't like that. How about you? Okay, so you are on, any, dating sites? You don't have to say which ones.
No, I'm not currently on any dating sites.
How do you find
Why
girls
not?
To date? Like, do you go to bars kind of thing?
Well, it's been a while since I've been on a date. Usually it's,
Or a hookup or whatever kids do these days. I don't know.
Just happenstance, usually friend of a friend. I'm not really
That's the best way. Yeah. That's the best way. Everyone's like this dating site. I'm like, then it never works out. It never works out. I always end up just meeting people through someone. I've been on a couple dates from dating sites, being single in the past, and they've all been so awful.
Yeah.
It's just better you're doing it the right way.
CougarLife.com?
But is there like something a woman could do? She's like trying to get you on. Is there something a woman could do that's like a red flag to you? Like you're automatically going to be like, nope, 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 nope.
Yeah, well, so I'll usually try and feel a girl out because I'm like very specific when it comes to dating. And so one of the first things I'll throw out is an abortion joke. It's my favorite thing to joke about. It's my
You mean an abortion joke to me?
To make sure they're down with abortion.
And I was so happy. I was make like, sure oh my God, he's so funny.
Down with the fucking coat hanger, right? In case right. drama comes up.
Yeah.
Yeah. So yeah, she said that. She liked that about you.
So I lead strong with some strong abortion stuff. And if they both have to like it and be into abortion. So I met some pro-life girls that still think the jokes are funny. And then they're like, well, we would never do that, though, for real, though. I'm like, oh. Next.
I know, between the two of us, he's got, double digits.
Frequent flyer miles.
Yeah. He was card punch. You know?
Man, yeah. It's like a way of life. That's where he met.
Yeah.
Abortion clinic.
The guy didn't show up. He was in a bagel suit.
Oh, my God,
the guy knocked me up was in a bagel suit for his acting career.
For his acting career, he was busy at being a sandwich model.
That was one of the times. Yeah. Anyways, you know what? I feel like it's 2015. People get abortions. Like, let's
hopefully.
Be honest about it. Yeah, hopefully.
We can still keep getting them.
Who is still like, I'm pregnant and I, you know, I got to do the right thing.
Thanks to Plan B, not so many people have to get abortions. But when I had an abortion, you know, I had an abortion when I was 30 and there was no Plan B. Plan B was waiting. Seeing if your tits hurt. Seeing if your tits hurt. And seeing if you yelled at your boyfriend when he lit up a cigarette, you know, when he lit up a Cool.
Oh, man, that must have been so hard. Oh.
It was hard, and that was it, you know?
I'm sorry that you had to go through that.
Oh, no Plan B, yeah. I know, right? It's I didn't even world, know you then, girl. I didn't even know you then, you know?
I've Plan B'd, C'd, D'd.
Yeah.
I've OD'd.
Life is, shit's getting better, people. It is.
The world's getting better science.
It is.
Fuck yeah.
It is. Don't listen to the naysayers or the doomsday people, although they're fun to hang out and party with.
So, should we do cold as fuck reading?
We should. It is time.
It is time. Do you feel warmed up? Do you feel like we've talked
vicious.
A little bit? We're going to ask you more questions if there's time. I don't know. I want to get everything in because we printed out these scripts, which I have.
Yay.
I don't know which scene this is or remember the movie, so we'll both be in the dark because she's going to direct it. That's usually how she's an amazing director. We did 7 for the Halloween episode. She was Morgan Freeman. I was Brad Pitt, and it was amazing. So we got Paris, Sally.
Thank you, love.
He doesn't have
it's
one.
Just a one-page script.
So I guess.
Oh, so I guess Hunter should have a script. Oh, they'll go get it if he doesn't have it. Yeah. But basically,
I got all the papers that were on the machine.
Oh, okay. Well, he can have mine. Oh, cool. The blanket is actually, we're good. I think, you know what? They can put the blanket over them. That would actually be good because they're in a, you guys are in a hotel room.
Yeah, we're
both going to be on the couch. I don't even need a script, really.
I'm going to put it on your sofa.
Oh, on my sofa. Okay, you guys. All right, cool.
All right,
so I'll get out of the way.
Let's move around.
Oh, that's fine. So, guys, I'll give you some nominal direction for the first read, and then we'll give you some adjustments. But basically, Sid and Nancy, you know, they're both in their early 20s. They do drugs. They do booze. They're lovers.
Lovers.
Yeah. So young.
I can't believe they were so
young.
This is a
real.
I didn't know.
That's how it always is. You think people are like, you know, so mature, and they're not. Oh, cool. They're going to show a little commercial and stuff. Yeah. So, but. Oh, okay. But you know, they were you know really young, and they went to see her family, and. Like, basically, the family were cool. They picked them up from the airport. They hung out all day at the family home with the grandparents and your siblings and your parents. But at the end of the day, they did say, oh, guys, you're not staying here. We're taking you to a hotel. They did not want you guys in the fucking house blowing it
rude.
Up and fucking and being
It says
weird.
Here, I'm morose.
Yeah.
So let me just
So
get
you're kind of like.
Oh my God, look at this.
Look at the fucking. Oh my God.
Fantastic. Look at us. Hey, mom.
So since this is cold AF readings, I am just going to treat this like an audition.
And
you're Lee Strasberg over here.
Yeah, I am Lee Strasberg with a much better ass.
Yes.
And I'm just going to tell you guys to like go ahead and just take a cold run at it, just like they would in an audition. And then I'll give you a little adjustment and we'll do it again.
Pretend like we're in an audition. Woo! All right, you're blocking my light, though. Okay, cool. I'm like, I am not going to do this with shadows on my face.
You guys take your time and then, you know, start.
I have a big monologue here. Okay, all right.
Yeah, take it slow.
All right. I'm morose.
And action.
Wow, what a cool place. Can't get over it. Pool table and all those games. Best fucking food I ever ate. Really nice people, too. Funny how they threw us out.
Oh, it's not their fault, Sid. All that stuff I told you, that's not even the half of it. I always used to fuck them up. What? What did I do to my parents? I always used to fuck them up when I would come and stay. I stole their car and I wrecked it twice. One time, I tried to burn their house down. It seems like I got arrested every time I left the house. See this scar? I did it to myself on purpose in Grandma's kitchen.
I thought I did that to you.
I did it the first time I tried to kill myself. I gave myself an abortion, too. Nobody but you can handle me.
I was really lonely when I was a nipper. What's a nipper? Me, life was full of people coming in and going out. I never made no friends, really. Never had no one, except me mom. I never liked her, but I loved her.
Red
I love
flag.
You more than anybody, Nance. Yeah, I like your character a lot. Gave herself an abortion.
You guys, that was adorable. Okay, it had a lot of sexual chemistry.
That was a really big paragraph. So.
It had a lot of sexual chemistry.
And it had some wine and stuff, so.
All right, directorial adjustment. First of all, you guys are completely great. All right, first of all, Hunter.
I fucked up. I want to do it over.
No, you guys are great. You guys are both. Okay, a side note to you. Paris, can you tuck your hair behind your ears?
Yeah,
because I want more face. Okay,
I know,
a little more beautiful face. Hunter, go ahead and try kind of like a Cockney accent,
okay.
A little bit. You know,
Mike.
He's from England. Yeah,
no
I mean that's
I'm
how
American,
he talks.
Right? Nancy was American. Right?
She's fucking American.
She's a Yankee.
She's actually a Yankee. She's from New York. If you really want to fucking, you know. She's that.
We have 2 minutes left on the show. Okay.
Yeah.
We cannot
really
do it
good.
Again because we have 2 minutes left.
What?
I know.
We
it goes
too much
so
fun.
Fast.
Oh
we have too
God.
Much fun on this show. And we might not even be able
I'll
to
just
retweet.
Do the
why
accent.
Don't you guys hug or something and I'll dance behind
retweet.
You? Hunter, tell. Oh,
where's
retweet.
My phone?
Oh, shit. Here's
okay.
My phone.
Oh, my God.
Oh, it's,
okay.
It's
we can't retweet for this show. We don't have time.
Yeah.
But I'm Paris Kennedy. You can find me at Paris Kennedy. On Twitter. We're back in the hotel room.
Woo!
I'm at Paris Kennedy on Twitter, and my website's pariskennedy.com. And just follow me there and join my website. And if you follow me on Twitter, I'm very active, and we'll talk about all the cool things I'm doing and all the cool projects I'm doing. Sally, your shit.
Hey, Sally Mullins, SallyMullins.com, military tour coming up, so follow me on Instagram, SallyMullins818, plenty of crazy pictures of what I'm doing over there. And our guest is so cool.
Let's
he's
see if
so
I can find
chill.
Well, you
we
plug yourself.
Him.
Woo!
Hunter like
Hudson,
it.
You can follow me at Hunter J. Hudson, and you can stop by and see me at the Josh and Josh Show on Thursday nights at Bar Lou Bitch, 8:30 p.m. every week.
And until I see the credits run, I'm going to check really quick to see if we have any tweets.
We have some good tweets.
Oh, we have
I'm
lots of
sure.
tweets. We see, it goes by so fast. Josh Volan says,
I love Josh
I never
Volan.
Had no friends, really. Next level dialogue. What is a sandwich model? Matt Mabry.
Yeah, right.
Sippy says, like, what kind of stuff can I tweet? My type. I don't think he's watching. Judd Travis says, I will join your Limp Bizkit cover band.
Yes.
Yes.
Judd, awesome. I talked to you about that, Judd. I'm dead serious. I'm, like, not even joking.
Do you play
it.
Bass?
Now you're in.
I have every instrument.
Fuck, dude.
I have it all. We got it all. Piper said a bunch of stuff.
She's awesome.
Too much. Y'all making me laugh.
We love some Piper.
Great lines, girls.
We're gonna put some pictures up. We're gonna picture.
We're gonna post some pictures. We're gonna take some pictures.
Watch them, retweet them, tweet them.
And God, I feel so less like this. We started so bitchy, but it's just hard. It's hard with like these cute boys to be bitchy.
I know, especially if they're nice. You know.
Fuck you, and also watch our Thanksgiving special, which we're gonna pre-record right after this. Drunk as fuck. Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you.
English style.
I'm gonna be Fred Durst, so I don't have to know how to play.
They didn't know how to play.
But everybody else does.
I didn't know how to play a fucking instrument.
Judd?
That's all the
figured out.
You're Judd Band.
You're me too. I'm gonna be Fred Durst, so I'm just gonna. You couldn't sing.
You just need a red baseball bat.
All I do is talk, sing. I just gotta talk, sing.
Just be angry.
Thank you.